Hey there guys, Neil here, back with an Android and iOS app review. So, you may have heard that Gmail recently got a UI redesign and overhaul, so it looks a lot cleaner, it has a lot more material design elements, nicer animations and things like that. But what Google also did was add a nice side pane to show and get quick access to your calendar, notes, post-it notes in Google Keep, along with a refreshed tasks pane. So what they did alongside updating that tasks pane is update and release apps for Android and iOS called Google Tasks to sync those tasks between Gmail on the web and your mobile device. So I figure I give the app a quick review, as it is actually a very simple and straightforward app. So upon installation, it is a free app. This is basically the UI. The menu on the bottom left gives you your account is tied with, your task, if it's tied to an email address, things like that. The ability to create a new list and go from there. The dots on the bottom right allows you to switch between whatever order you want and a date order. So it depends on how you want to see it, is the order that you can put it in with. So in the app itself, what you'll do in order to create the task is obviously click on add a new task, and you can either do a one by one task list, or you can create categories and create subtasks. So for example, if you need to create a task for, let's say follow up, and you can, follow up, then you have that list, and then you can create a subtask from this menu, or you can let's say call the dude, and you now have a subtask. But let's say you decide that it's not really a subtask, you can hold down and you can drag it and make it a regular main task, and vice versa. So from here, if you want to make this a subtask, you can move it and do it like that. Creating the add a new task button allows you to do a similar thing. So let's say you create a task for, let's say you pick up the dry cleaning and hit save, and you realize that you need, now that it's a task, is something that you had a task to do, but now that you've dropped it off, you need to pick it up, you can drag it and make it a subtask. So that's pretty much it. So what you see here as far as your tasks go will sync to Gmail on the web. So when you go to gmail.com and you have the new UI, you can click on the logo. It looks a lot like this logo that you see here. And you'll see any tasks that are listed under My Tasks or under your email addresses. A task list, so it's separated in those two areas, but you have easy access to those tasks, and it's also something that syncs from Gmail on the web down to the app. So when you're on the go, and if you need a refresher for your task, that is available. The only downside is that there's no reminders like you see in Google Keep, so that is one of those things that kind of is a drawback for now. But you can set dates, so if you need to do a follow-up for a specific date, you can do that. I want to say it'll sync with your calendar, but at least on the 17th, you can set a notification for when you need to do that particular task. And from here, you can add more subtasks. And then once you complete those tasks, if you touch the dot, it'll mark it as complete. So that way, when you're done, it doesn't show up anymore, and you don't have to worry about remembering if it's done or not. And if you click on the completed tab, you'll see that they're checked off and marked across, they have a strike through showing that they're complete. And then let's say you click on something by mistake, you can touch it again, and it'll put it back to your task list as something to follow up with. So that's all there is for that. The app is available, as I mentioned, for Android and iOS. It is a free app, so definitely worth checking out, and it's synced to your specific Google/Gmail account. So that's all there is for that. So if you have any questions, comments, concerns, anything like that, you can find me on Twitter at PatelN01. You can find the podcast and all subscription links, all of that good stuff, on the website at PatelN01.com. And of course, if you want to help support the show, get content early and all of that good stuff, then you can visit the Patreon at patreon.com/PatelN01. But that is all for this particular review. Thanks for watching and listening, and until next time.